What of yours have been kind of your favorite? Which are the ones that you either like personally or that you found within the writing of your book, Hidden in Plain View?
Well, you know, C.S. Lewis said about the novels of Dickens that his favorite always seemed to be the one he had read last. So I feel that way a little bit about Undesigned Coincidence. It's my favorite. It's always the one I've discovered most recently. You know, it's the one that then I'm that one's the freshest. It's the one I'm the most excited about. So I'm going to give an example that's not in Hidden in Plain View. So
ooh, this I'm is a little add bit this to the back of the book. Then.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, it's going to be in I don't believe it's in The Mirror of the Mask either. It's going to be in The Eye of the Beholder, though, that I'm writing right now. So in Mark 3:22, we find that it says that leaders and messengers had come from Jerusalem to Galilee, and they were listening to Jesus teach, and he was casting out demons, and they said, "You cast out demons by Beelzebul, the prince of the demons." So they're very hostile to him. And it's weird, you know, because in Mark, if you just read Mark, there hasn't been any conflict yet between Jesus and the leaders down in Jerusalem. I mean, he's hardly been in Jerusalem that we've seen. We haven't seen him in Jerusalem hardly at all. And here they are, and Galilee was not right next door. You know, it was a good 70, 80 miles. In Michigan terms, imagine walking from here to Grand Rapids to go give some guy a hard time, basically. Okay? You know, it's just like, why would you do that? Okay? It's very complicated and confusing as to why they were so hostile. But when we go to John, and we go to John 2, we find Jesus cleansing the temple early in his ministry. And he's a little cheeky. They go up to him and say, "Give us a sign by which you will show us that you have authority to do that." They're like, "Who do you think you are?" You know, throwing out these merchants and so forth. And he says, "Destroy this temple and in 3 days I will raise it up," which is not really the answer they were looking for, you know. So the idea, I think, is that they sent messengers then. You know, when he went back to Galilee, they sent messengers saying, "Go check this guy out. You know, he came and he caused a disturbance in the temple," and they're already very negatively inclined toward him. Okay, they're going to try to find something to use against him. But what's interesting is that some scholars will say that John moved the temple cleansing, that Jesus didn't cleanse the temple early in his ministry. But this Undesigned Coincidence actually shows that he did cleanse the temple early in his ministry. And there are many other indications that he did. This is just one small part of the case, but that he appears to have already had a clash in Jerusalem, specifically with the Jerusalem leaders. So their messengers are mentioned in Mark as coming all the way to Galilee to investigate him.
Mm-hmm.